right? First foremost, I'm going to say all praises be to Yahweh, Bashim, Al-Shai, Bashim, Rakakodash. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of great millstone. Shalom to the sincere elect, teaching this truth and faith and sincerity through the spirit and power of Yahweh, Bashim, Al-Shai, Bashim, Rakakodash. Quick topic on a speak on, man, is this earthquake and situation that's happening, man, in Haiti. You know, and it's very interesting, I'll say, you know, that, you know, it's interesting what a couple, like, I think it was last month sometime, the president of over there got killed, you know. And if you know, it's interesting that, you know, that country is a country that's against the JABs, you know. It's interesting, you know, like, well, when the former president was alive, he was coming up against it, man, you know. So ultimately speaking, whether Esau uses his systems to engineer this, or it's just a natural, so you know, as people say, a natural thing, it still is down to the Heavenly Father anyway, man, right? Because he ultimately controls good and evil. And whether a person gets hit by a falling rock off a mountain, or Esau engineers a thing and people die, it's still controlled by the Lord, man. So before I read a bit in the article, I'm gonna read this scripture first. This is Psalm 68 and 20. He that is our power is the power of salvation, and unto Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai belong the issues from death, man. So whether a person lives or dies, it's down unto our Lord, man, right? And you know, I like as the Apostle Taha explained, like a very large percent of the population over there are Catholic, man. And you know, in some way, shape, form, you just know, in some way, shape, or form, they've come across this this understanding, man, and the truth. And at the same time, you know, not saying every single person in there in that country does voodoo, but you know, that's also what it's also known for over there, man. So ultimately, it's judgment, man. So you see all these signs and these wars and rumors of wars and these earthquakes in diverse places that's taking place. These are all signs and a rehearsal for when the Lord comes. Because remember, the scripture says that when the Lord comes, that the earth shall reel to and fro as a drunkard, man. So when the Lord comes with his chariots and his missiles and things are happening, trust me, you know, trust what the scripture says. More earthquakes and of greater magnitude that people have never seen before will take place when he comes, man, right? So let's go into this article. It says Haiti earthquake, the death toll jumps to 724 people. And by now, because this was 5 hours ago, it's probably 1,000 plus. And think about us, 1,000 plus people just getting taken out in a one go. You know, that's heavy, man. And it says what? The Haiti earthquake death toll jumps to 724 people as storm expected to hit devastated Caribbean country. right? And I've seen some videos of it. I'm not gonna, you know, play the videos, but I've seen some videos, you know, and you see the pictures and the videos of kids just lie down on the street dead, man. You know, you actually see the videos of just kids just dead. You know, you're knocked out, just on the floor dead, man. It says officials have raised the death toll from a devastating earthquake in Haiti to 724. And remember, that's 724 of what they can find. It's probably thousands, probably to 2,000, with thousands more injured. And you just know, like, aside from the actual earthquake, there's probably all kind of stuff taking place. All right, there's obviously people have died, then the people who are left, who are alive, are probably still trying to, you know, find food and supplies and, you know, water. You know, people are probably stealing food out of certain environments. You know, like the possessions of those who are dead are probably getting taken off them, you know, if any. Oh, it says with a devastating earthquake in Haiti to 724, with thousands more injured, and those injuries could also be a injury unto death, man. It, like, at some point, you know, it says reeling, right? Reeling from the quake, which is spiritual, the earth shall reel to and fro. The Caribbean country is now bracing itself from a tropical storm. That's terrible, man. But it's judgment. Can you imagine you've had an earthquake that's killed 1,000+ people, and now a storm gonna take place, which that storm could lead to floods and make things more complicated of trying to find people that are underneath there, man. So that's going down over there. It says Haiti's Civil Protection Agency raised the death toll on Sunday morning after the country was shaken by a magnitude 7.2 earthquake. The quake struck the island's nation's southern peninsula, collapsing buildings in several towns and leaving the streets strewn with rubble. You know? And, you know, there's obviously some pictures of it. But look, like, that's that these pictures ain't even, no, it's bad, but it's not even that bad in comparison to the actual, you know, official pictures and videos that can't be posted on online, like on YouTube. You know, I've seen videos of kids just laid out. You know, the face taken off. A government press release noted that 500 people have been killed in the south of the country, and you know, like, a person might reread these totals, but 500 souls is that's a lot of souls, bro, to go in one go. That's the angels, man, of death over there. A government press release noted that 500 people had been killed in the south of the country, 100 in the area of Gradance, 122 in the town of Nepis, and 2 in the northwest, and that more than 2,800 people had been injured. So if 2,800 people like are injured, how much of the people of them is injuries unto death, and how much of them are people that can't be found? Remember, they only count a person's death until they're found, and after a while, once certain people can't be accounted for, they just add that to the toe, man. You know? And as it said, you see, here it says, so basically, they've experienced, like, aftershocks as well. A 5.8 magnitude tremor rocks Haiti as it rose from devastating quake, you know. And then of course, as the article said, it says a storm as well. The storm is currently moving northwest near Puerto Rico and expected to affect Haiti and the Dominican Republic by Monday or Tuesday, with wind speeds currently around 64 kilometers. Right? Grace could deluge Haiti with up to 25 centimeters of rain, which is 10 inches. Which, again, you can imagine, like, a tropical storm and an earthquake in the space of a couple of days, man. That's the spirit, you know, of the Lord, man. And again, you know, those people there, you know, in some way, shape or form, they've come across the truth. And, you know, that place is known for all sorts of witchcraft. But at the end of the day, these plagues and pestilences and storms and tempests and things are happening throughout the earth. You know, the past month and a half, for 2 months, there's been storms in Belgium, France, and Germany. I believe in Germany, like, over 100 people died, if I'm not mistaken. And then you obviously have the wildfires in Turkey, Greece. And then there's more information on the jabs. There's more information that everything's coming out. Everything's happening at one time, man, because it's that time. Right? This is let me get a... This is Amos 3:6. Shall a trumpet be blown in the city, and the people not be afraid? Shall there be evil in a city, and the Lord have not done it? So that's the power, man. So, you know, so the scripture is saying, if there's it basically is saying, like, a rhetorical question, man, if there's evil takes place in a town or a city, then it's 100% that is the Lord doing it, man, because he controls both sides, right? This is a Deuteronomy 30. What am I doing? Deuteronomy 32 and 29. It says, no, 32. No, I always get you a mix up. Okay. Deuteronomy 32 and 39. Yeah, I was right. 32 and 39. He says, "See now that I am he, and there's no power with me. I kill and I make alive. I wound and I heal. Neither is there any that can deliver out of my hand, for I lift up my hand to heaven and say, I live forever." So The scripture says the Lord, he kills and makes alive. He wounds and heals, man. So in terms of what was taking place, man, that was down to the Lord, man. Right? Because he controls both sides. You know, and it's more or less a warning. Because the scripture says the isles moved. Move. It says to move out of a place. It says something like that. Move. I don't think I can find it. You know. Oh yeah, this is Revelation 6 and 14, and the heaven departed as a scroll when it is rolled together. That's talking about the mushroom clouds when the ICBMs hit America, man. You know, in this war, and every mountain and island were moved out of their places, because when these missiles hit the earth, is hitting different parts of the earth, especially when it hits America, man. Like, the whole earth gonna feel it, man. The scripture says the earth shall reel to and fro as far as a drunkard, man. So certain of these Caribbean islands that's off the coast of America might just fucking, you know, not saying for sure, but might just go underwater and shit, or have multiple earthquakes. Because at times, you know what happens? Explosions can cause earthquakes. You know, cause, and then if you have blasts that are very, very loud, and they hit a fault line or a certain tectonic plate, it can cause even more earthquakes, man. You know, because at the end of the day, that all happening is down to the Lord, man. This is a Surah 39 and 28, right? It says there'll be spirits that are created for vengeance, which in their fury lay on sore strokes. In a time of the destruction, they pour out their force and appease the wrath of him that made him. Fire, hell, famine, and death. All these were created for vengeance. Teeth of wild beasts, scorpions, serpents, and the sword punishing the wicked to destruction. They shall rejoice in his commandment, and they shall be ready upon earth when need is. And when their time has come, they shall not transgress his word. So there'll be spirits created for vengeance. So when these type of events happen, there's actually an angel, a particular angel who has been instructed to make it happen. You know, so there'll be spirits created for vengeance, man. You know, so that's all that's happening there is the judgment of the Lord, man. And again, it's a sign for his son's coming back. When his son comes back, it really gonna be a dark day. You know, things really gonna be happening, man. Right. So the last scripture I'm gonna get is 2 Ezra 9. Right. He answered me then and said, "Measure out the time diligently in itself, and when thou seest part of the signs past which I told thee before, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made. Therefore, when there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people in the world, then shall I well understand that the Most High spake of those things from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning." And people will be like, "Yeah, well, the earthquakes have always happened, though." Yeah, they've always happened, but it's never been like this scale, man. Right? There's constant earthquakes, there's constant uprisings of people, right? People are protesting. People have been protesting this whole summer, right? And, you know, first, people was protesting because of BLM and certain things, and now there's people who are protesting against the JAB, man. You know, there's people that are protesting against these things, man, and it's gonna get worse. So once parents, you know, feel the strain and pressure, you know, I saw a video the other day of an Edomite said, you know, if you wanna come and give me a SHOT, you gonna have to get a SHOT first. And when what he meant by that is that, look, man, if you wanna come and try and enforce me, well, before you stick that SHOT in me, you might get SHOT'd or the gun. So that's how you know things are changing, man. Right? And it's a powerful time. It's a heavy time. It's a time of prophecy, man. So with that, I'm gonna say, oh, praises be to Yahweh, Shimon, Shabbat, Shimon, Kakadosh, double honors, puzzles, and elders of great most dome. Till next time, I'm gonna say, Shalom.